Hello guys, once again we're here, me and Wolf. This is a dog, a guard dog, a ferocious German Shepherd. Okay, that's a dog. So let's leave Wolf and go back to our Bow Street. Since yesterday, last of the time that I made a video, I have painted black and the paint is dry. For some reason that I do not understand, the paint is dry completely in the entire part except from this part here. Here it's a little bit sticky. And this is the African walnut, so I believe it has to do something with the texture of the wood, probably. Okay, nothing to worry about. Everything needs varnishing here at the metallic parts, but that's not what I'm going to do right now. I'm going to do it later. First of all, I'm going to scratch off the paint from this part here and everywhere else that the paint in the metallic surfaces that the paint went, that I don't want it. And as you can see, I have gathered my materials to complete the bowsprit. So let me scratch the paint from the metallic surfaces and I'll get back to you to get starting finishing the bowsprit. So guys, let's begin. First of all, let's insert the pulley that I have painted gold to match everything else. This is going to be an easy job. The pulley goes in here and above a small nail. So, the pulley is in position. Let's try to tie these threads. Here you can see we have 5 rows. Here we have 9 rows. The thread I'm going to use is this one, is 0.50. It's brown. And let's see where I have to tie them up. So I have to tie 9 here, 9 here, and 9 here before the pulley. I believe let me check a photo. Yeah, exactly, before the pulley. So, let's begin. The first part is the hard one. So, let's continue. Like I said, the first part is the hard one. And this makes it 9. And now that's it. A drop of glue to secure everything. And I have it, the first 9. With the same way, I'm going to make the rest 2 fives. So let me do that and I'll get back to you. And I have it also here. The worst thing with the paint is that I need to varnish everything, but that's going to be easy, it's not hard. I'm going to do that after placing everything, except of course from the threads. I'm not going to find the threads. So next step, I'm going to open up 3 holes here in the side, 2 on the top, another 3 on the side, and place some rings. No need to film about that. That's nothing strange that I haven't done before. So let me do that and I'll get back to you. Ready? The rings are attached in position. Now, we have to place the pulleys and blocks and everything and the dies and whatever this bowsprit needs for the yards and sails to be attached on. And I can tell you that it's extremely boring. This is the part that I hate. It's very boring. Just tying knots and placing these pieces up on. I love passing the ropes through them and make the rigging, but I hate that part. It's extremely boring. So let's do a couple of those together and I'll do the rest of them myself. The thread that we're going to use is the 015. We have also some hairs of wolf here. First one, let's place this one. paste, and you have it. So the first one goes here. The easiest, quickest way is twist. A drop of glue. Also some glue along the way to make it stay there. Okay, first one in position. With the same way, exactly the same way, I'm going to place the second one. So let's place a couple of these dead eyes we have. Let's see, I have one here. I must have somewhere a couple of those here. Okay, this goes, those underneath goes over here. Same way, exactly the same way. This is plastic. It does not absorb the glue. That's a problem. So this is going between the first and the second underneath here. So, with the same way, I'm going to place all the pulleys, the dies and stuff, and I'll get back to you to mount it on the ship. So guys, as you can see, a lot of stuff. Let me focus. A lot of stuff over here. And I have it in position. And now it's the hard part. I have to tie it over here. This is going to be hard, and also to tie these two over here at the bow. Give me a moment. Now we have light over here at the bow. at least yes, at these two holes. This where these two dead eyes will go with another two dead eyes. And after that, I will varnish the entire part here, except for the threads, of course, and whichever part I need to do. Let me see if I can film this part here, because it's going to be very hard. I have to pass the thread through these gratings, all over here, up to here, above, and again and again and again, many many times. Let me see if I can do that. Now guys, I'm not going to do the entire part in camera, because it's very time consuming, very hard, and the camera is on the way. So what we have to do is place several times, 7, 8, 9, 10 times, I don't know how many, I will see. It depends from this gap here, this hole, a rope that goes all over the bowsprit, inside here, outside here, all over, inside this hole, and returns from the other side exactly the same way, and that's hard. So let's begin. First of all, I have to make this end a little bit hard. So I will be able to pass it through without the rope getting destroyed. Now this end, I will keep it, I don't know how long, I will have it as long as the bench. No, that's the idea. The first to be like this, and the second to come all over. Probably some glue will do the trick. So guys, this is how it's going to be done. It needs a lot of time. When I'm at the end, when I need to tie it up, I will get back to you to do some more filming. Now, as you have seen, can see, I have made some passes around. This is the first the edge of the rope when I started at the beginning, and this is the other edge. Now what I have to do is tie this. It wasn't easy, I can assure you. Now it's not going to be easy either. I have to tie this, but I have to tie it here at the center. So to be able to maintain the height, I'm using the same rope. Let me see if I can show you. And I'm passing it under. So with that way, I have a noose and I'm able to adjust the height. Like this. Of course, I'm going to use a drop of glue to secure it, so I will be able to work freely. Okay, have it. Just a drop of glue. I know that the bowsprit is in the way, but it's going to be a lot hard to feel on the other side, because on the other side it's me, and because I'm right-handed I need to be on this side. Didn't did its job. So that's the idea. Let me do that and I'll get back to you to do this front type tying within the dies. Now guys, let's do the dead eyes thing. Here I see I need to open up the hole. Let me do that. Now let's pass the rope. Let's do the top one first. So, where's the thread? Let me find the thread. Got it. Yeah, 015. This is an ingenious tool I'm using to pass the threads through the blocks, the dies, the pulleys. Many of you ask me where to get it. I got it from a local store that sells threads and needles. First of all, tie a knot here. A simple knot is good. Always some glue to secure the nuts. You don't want anything to be untied when some strengths are applied. Now, let's see. Probably I'm going to use this. I cut it a little more than I need. Okay. That's it. That's the first one. The same way I'm going to do the second one. So let me do that, let me varnish it so it will look beautiful, and I'll get back to you to show you the finishing result. And done, guys. Give me a moment. Now we have some light. It's varnished. It's shiny, it's black, it's beautiful. This is a very, very long ship. I can tell you that. So, this was, guys, the phase 2 of the bowsprit and also the mounting on the boat. Me and Wolf. We say bye bye for now. See you on our next video, where we're going to begin to make the masts.